It's now been 1 year since Manchester United signed a little fella called Bruno Fernandes from Sporting. And what a year it has been. It's clear to see that Bruno Fernandes has been nothing short of a revelation since he joined Manchester United, and probably one of our most consistent performers ever, and certainly over the last year. I can remember when we was looking at signing him, trying to do a little bit of scouting. There was Nations League games on where we were being linked to him, watching him going, is he good? He looks all right, I guess. Like, I don't think he's going to do the sort of numbers we saw in Portugal and England, though. Far from that. But where did it all start? Before he came to Manchester United, before he ended up at Sporting, Bruno's been around the block a little bit. He's now probably the best player at Manchester United. He's probably one of the world's best midfielders. Let's have a look where he came from. In his teenage years, Bruno Fernandes lived in Portugal, near Porto, and things were a struggle for him and his family. His old man, José Fernandes, was unemployed and struggling to provide for the family due to the Portuguese financial crisis. He chose to emigrate to Switzerland in search of a job, and the idea was to take his wife and three children with him. But Bruno, his middle son, refused to go. Playing in the Boa Vista youth team at the time, Bruno wasn't willing to quit on his football dream, and he allegedly repeated to his parents that in Switzerland, they don't know how to play football. After a bit of a dispute, Bruno was able to stay in Portugal and managed to chase his football dreams, becoming a professional footballer. His dad went abroad, whilst his mum remained with Bruno in Portugal on the outskirts of Maia, about 15 minutes away from Porto. Whilst playing for Boa Vista under-19s in Portugal, he was spotted by a scout from Italian side Novara in Serie B. He received a bit of a tempting offer to move to Italy. Bruno was keen to move away if it meant that it would give him a chance to play football at a higher level. So Novara and Boa Vista agreed a fee of €40,000. And a 17-year-old Bruno Fernandes packed his bags for Italy in August 2012. Now, Bruno initially suffered from a little bit of homesickness, but after teaching himself Italian, which, fair play, he grew into his new environment and he helped Novara secure fifth position in Serie B. After impressing in his first season, he got a move to Udinese in Italy's top division for a transfer fee of £2.25 million. He spent 3 years in Udinese, scored 11 goals in 95 appearances, and was enough to convince Sampdoria to clinch his signature in August 2016 with a loan move and an obligation to be signed permanently. This was shortly after playing at the Rio Olympics with Portugal's under-23s. By this time, Fernandes was developing into a bit of a leader himself, and he actually captained Portugal's 2017 under-21 championship campaign. And it was after this tournament where Bruno was brought back to Portugal. Sporting Lisbon decided that a fee of £8.73 million would be enough to bring him back to Portugal.
Olá, Sportingistas. Queria-vos deixar uma mensagem de até já.
He was seen as a playmaker after originally thriving in Italy as a bit of an Andreas Pirlo sort of sitting midfielder, quarterback sort of midfielder, deep line playmaker, if you like. But he would soon perform to an even higher level, pushed further forward in the attacking midfield role that we know now. Playing alongside former United star Nani in the Sporting midfield, Fernandes' first season back in his home country was a resounding success. He contributed 16 goals and 20 assists, which is enough to win both team and individual honours, with Sporting claiming the Portuguese League Cup and Fernandes being awarded Premier League Player of the Year. His efforts in the 17-18 season saw him get a call up for the Portugal squad for the 2018 World Cup in Russia, and he featured against Spain and Iran, with the European champions eventually being knocked out by Uruguay in the last 16. While in Russia, you might remember the controversy, seven senior members of the Sporting club cancelled their contracts. Fernandes was one of those seven, but upon his return in July, he did sign a new deal and immediately took on more of a leadership role within the team. Never really a prolific goal scorer in Italy, something clicked in the 18-19 season. Fernandes hit an incredible 20 goals from midfield, assisting a further 13. His involvement in 33 league goals was the highest of any midfielder in Europe's leading leagues, and he was once again recognised as Premier League Player of the Year as Sporting finished third in the league. The team also took home the Portuguese Cup and repeated their League Cup triumph from just 12 months previous. After Nani's departure to Orlando City in February 2019, Fernandes was named captain of Sporting Lisbon. And from there, the links with Manchester United started. There was heavy links, although there was apparently no intention of the club signing him. The summer we brought Harry Maguire and Wan-Bissaka to the club, but come the January, obviously those links intensified. Now for me, it looks like the clubs aren't in full agreement on this transfer just yet. Sporting are saying one price, United are saying another. That tells me that both sides are briefing what they want to their respective press. And on January 27th, 2020, he played his final game for Sporting Lisbon after accumulating a total of 63 goals and 52 assists in just 137 games for Sporting. These outrageous numbers meant that an agreement was made with Manchester United to bring the Portuguese midfielder to Old Trafford for £46.5 million. Bruno Fernandes to Manchester United, all confirmed. Mint.
Manchester United are finally poised to land their number one transfer target and potentially the biggest signing of the January transfer window. A deal has been agreed for Bruno Fernandes.
As I record this video, Bruno is just under a goal contribution a game. Tons of goals, tons of assists. And I think it's safe to say in 2020 he had an unbelievable year. In the Premier League in 2020, Bruno made 32 goal contributions in 29 games, the most of any player. He's recently been awarded the Player of the Month for December, which means that the United star claims the prize for the second successive month and becomes the first ever four-time winner in a calendar year when football was paused and he wasn't even here for one of the months. Where would United be without Bruno Fernandes? I think his story is just beginning at Manchester United. I think there's trophies. I don't know whether there's leagues because he's going to need more players around him. But he's had a phenomenal start to life at Manchester United. The only players that I could compare his impact to is Eric Cantona and Robin Van Persie. And they joined better squads with Sir Alex Ferguson at the helm. And they did manage to win a league, deservedly so. Bruno Fernandes deserves a title. It's whether or not United can match the rest of the 11 around him to deliver it.